Good morning, Mario, and good morning, Switch fans. Happy new week. Hope you're all doing well. Got some sleep, some rejuvenation over the weekend. Nintendo, they decided to stir the pot a bit this morning, and maybe they're ready to open the oven and enlighten us on what's gonna happen in the next couple months. But they definitely dropped some Mario Golf nuggets, and it really seems like a Pokemon Presents is right around the corner. We got the details on that, plus plenty more, including a very special new Pokemon Snap dock that I really like. So what's going on, everybody? It's Zach from SwitchForce. Hope you're all doing amazing. Smash that like button and let me know in the comments down below how you feel about this. Mario Golf Super Rush just got its big trailer. I posted a nice video, kind of a comprehensively going over the new features and the new characters, but I found something out that is kind of souring, and it's a bit of a downer, but I have to give you the update. Well, first, something kind of funny. Mario and Luigi are almost always all-around characters. Like, they're the literal definition of a smack dab in the middle, median, mediocre, medium character. You think about their appearances in sports titles and fighting games. In Mario Golf Super Rush, Mario and Luigi are speed characters. I don't know. They must have converted all that plumber fat into pure muscle, because they are speed alongside Daisy and Yoshi, and Wario and Waluigi are the all-around characters this time around. Wario and Waluigi, two characters that really are the antithesis of all-around. I mean, one is short and squat, one is tall and kind of evil. Doesn't make any sense. They also incorporated Rosalina as all-around when Rosalina was mysteriously a heavy character in Mario Kart 8. Which, I don't know, that dress must be made out of space steel. This is very odd and very strange, but the sad part is, the Japanese Mario Golf website claims there are 6 courses. Now, I just got done making a video, which you should check out, about all the characters. 16 plus a lot of room for DLC. I surely hope that the courses have room for DLC as well, because 6 honestly isn't a ton. Okay, especially since a few of them look like variations on forest slash golf course looking golf courses. There is a cool Bowser's Castle lava course and a nice sandy desert course, but I really hope we at least get 10 courses. Maybe they'll bring them in via DLC. I'm not sure, but hopefully we get more. The game, though, is shaping up amazing. It looks like they really have emphasized the party elements, the fun multiplayer, and are trying to give it that broad appeal, which I do appreciate. Now, Nintendo normally keeps their limited edition stuff pretty limited. They're not the biggest fans of broad appeal. They like to make it very hard to get. In fact, I don't know if you can even buy most of the limited edition Pro Controllers anymore. Like the Xenoblade Chronicles 2, Splatoon 2, Smash Bros. Ultimate. I think those are very hard to find and may even be kind of pricey on eBay. Nintendo has dipped their toes into delicious docks. They delivered the first alternate color dock earlier this year with the red dock alongside Mario 3D World, and now they have a Pokemon Snap dock. Except, get this, there's only one of them. One. Okay, this is the most limited edition Nintendo Switch accessory ever. It is a lovely dock with Meganium and Pichu, and it's just a very fun dock with its typical, you know, very subtle white outlines. And it's being given away via Korokoro magazine in Japan. You have to submit your best new Pokemon Snap photo, and somebody's gonna get it. I hope that Korokoro judges based on artistry and awesome photos and not via the Professor Mira method, because that dude, he doesn't really understand the beauty of art. He more just wants the Pokemon straight in the center. What about the rule of thirds? Okay, what about multiple subjects? What about composition? I hope that they know how to judge that, because that doc is pretty swanky. And there's only one of them. I'm very curious what the other limited editions will be later this year. We got the Zelda Skyward Sword Joy-Con. We got a Monster Hunter Rise Pro Controller. Are we going to get another special edition Switch? It feels almost inevitable. But you know, I'm down for more of the controllers. I feel those are more additive, right? You can add a new set of Joy-Con, you can add a new Pro Controller if you're a really big fan of the franchise. It's kind of hard to justify a whole new Switch. Unless you play Animal Crossing and want a new island. Okay, let's get on to something a little more intriguing. Pokemon typically loves to do their things at their own pace. They're not often a part of Nintendo's normal plans. Like, obviously their games are integrated and Nintendo talks about them, but the Pokemon Company loves to operate independently. So as we approach E3, it seems like it's time for Pokemon news. And we got our big rumor from Kelios FR over on Twitter, a pretty reliable guy who has correctly predicted recent Pokemon presentations as well as the Diamond and Pearl remakes, and he's just been kind of spot on. He's really kind of tightened up his operation, and he only says things if he believes in it. And he says that there is going to be a Pokemon Presents in early June to announce the Pokemon Unite release date, the Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl release dates, and more. So this feels like it's kind of a, you know, cleaning house Pokemon Presents, but I bet there is more than meets the eye. And whether that's new Pokemon Legends footage or whether that's something totally different, these presentations oftentimes do like to introduce spin-offs. In fact, we have had an E3-centric, E3 timeframe Pokemon Presents the last 3 years, 2020, 2019, 2018. And they all have announced something quirky, like Pokemon Quest, Pokemon Unite, Pokemon Masters. So yeah, Pokemon Presents, it's a rumor, but it's pretty much a reality. Look at the data, it all makes sense. That's why hashtag trust SwitchForce is a thing for Animal Crossing, because I'm always looking at the data, I'm always basing it on facts and the past and trying to give you guys the best idea of what's gonna happen. I really take a deep look at all the data, all of the info, all the rumors, all the leaks, and then parse it together and say, huh, what makes the most sense? What has Nintendo done in the past? And what can that teach us about the future? And it teaches us that there's almost assuredly gonna be a Pokemon Presents in the next couple of weeks. I mean, we're getting close there. We're getting there. And, you know, Detective Pikachu 2 has a high chance of making an appearance. It is the 25th anniversary of Pokemon, so there's a chance that you could get something extra special. I've seen this really bad rumor floating around, so I just wanna nix this for you, that Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl is getting an art overhaul. That's just not happening. I know some people were bummed about the chibi look of the characters, but like, they're not redoing the game because of some Twitter outrage. It's just not happening. So cross that one off. But yeah, Detective Pikachu 2, stealth drop of Pokemon Unite, or a very close drop. I don't think we're gonna get another Switch game because they kind of played their cards. They showed us the ace in the hole with Pokemon Legends that's coming out next year, but we could get more footage of that, maybe an expanded look on what that game actually is, instead of just lush landscapes and trying to be Breath of the Wild, but with Ash Ketchum. I'm excited nonetheless, because we're gonna get a Direct, we're gonna get a Pokemon Presents. It's coming together, and this is about to be the most exciting time of the year. Before we get to the poll, I wanna wrap it around and just say that I think it would be delightful if Nintendo dropped a demo for Mario Golf Super Rush. The game is out June 25th, so they still have about 6 weeks, but I feel like this title would benefit dramatically from giving players who aren't golf fans a chance to see if this game has appeal. Because I think it really does, but I'm worried that players that aren't familiar with Tiger Woods, Sergio Garcia, Phil Mickelson, and the likes aren't going to give it a fair shake. I hope today's trailer changed that, and I hope you'll give it a chance, because Tennis Aces did a great job of overcoming the tennis game and becoming just like a really fun multiplayer game. It seems like golf is even going more in that direction with the battle mode, with the speed golf mode, and just with like all the fun characters, the fashion, the story mode, the boss battles. It's gonna be great, but I might have my eye out for a demo. It seems like that's something that Nintendo could do. Okay, my poll today was about what Nintendo is gonna do. You guys can look forward to the polls every evening over on the community tab of the channel. Make sure to turn those notifications on so you know and can be a part of it. I asked, you only get one of these games in 2021, what you picking? And I gave you kind of like what I think are the two big guesses for a big holiday game, if there's a big holiday game, and that would be Mario Kart 9 or Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild 2. And honestly, the winner did not surprise me, but I was happy to see the balance. Breath of the Wild 2 obviously won, but with 67% of the vote, 33% of you, myself included, picked Mario Kart 9. And I think that's pretty cool. Obviously, a new Zelda is like the biggest thing. It's the anniversary year, everybody's so hyped for Link. Do they bring in co-op? What's Zelda like? How are they gonna rework Breath of the Wild to make it even better 4-5 years later? Now, there's been back and forth on if this comes out in 2021, 2022, we don't know. But it should appear at E3. Mario Kart 9, a bit more of a wild card, but hey, there's been leaks saying, hey, it's been in the works for a couple of years now. Nintendo does wanna make a new game, and I love Mario Kart. I will be happy with either. Any of those, like, if we get a big holiday game, I'm happy. Because we didn't really get a big holiday game, per se, for a while now. Like, Smash Bros. Ultimate, that's a huge holiday game. Mario Odyssey, that's a huge holiday game. I'm talking something of that caliber. Animal Crossing New Horizons, you know, it got pushed to March, so it became a huge spring game. I would love another big heavy hitter. The idea of racing against all you guys in a brand new kart racer with new characters and all new courses. I've been playing the 8 courses for almost a decade. That is my favorite Nintendo game of the last decade, so you can see why I picked MK9, but we're gonna find out soon. It's like, it's getting really close. I'm so excited we get to share it together. Thanks for all your support. Thanks for always loving me and my work. I appreciate you guys so much. It keeps me going, and hopefully I keep your weeks going strong. Start this one off good, okay? You got probably a lot going on, a lot to do, a lot of overwhelm. I really find it beneficial to take a deep breath, give yourself like 3 to 5 things you're grateful for, and try to move forward with power. And that doesn't mean you have to be ultimately happy and perky and perfectly positive, but it just means like, hey, I'm gonna accomplish what I need to accomplish, I'm gonna move through it, and then I'm gonna make my way towards something more fun. Give yourself goals, give yourself things to look forward to, reward yourself a little bit more medium term. It doesn't have to be an instant gratification thing, and it doesn't have to be months off for vacation. Just be like, hey, I'm really looking forward to playing this game tonight, or I can't wait to see my best friend this weekend. And make sure you're staying safe, staying healthy, staying happy, staying positive out there. I love you guys a lot. Until next time, Good Morning Mario comes back in just another day. I'll see you then. SwitchForce out.